Om Sri Sai Ram, Prasanthi Sandesh welcomes you. That experience is very, very fresh in my memory that I wanted to share with you in this episode. I was serving as the state president of Sri Sai organizations, Andhra Pradesh, for over 4 years. It so happened during that time, I happened to visit a place by name Siricilla in Telangana State. I requested another professor, Sri Subrahmanya Sarma garu, who was serving as the principal of A.V.M college at Visakhapatnam. Both of us traveled to Siricilla. We participated at the meeting and we're back to the station, and we have to catch the next train, Godavari Express, at Khazipet railway station. Khazipet is the junction in the state of Telangana. So we reached Khazipet. From there we had to board Godavari Express to our places. Subrahmanya Sarma garu was to go to Visakhapatnam and I was to go to Guntur, where I was working. Well, as we reached Khazipet railway station, suddenly the superintendent of railway station happened to see me from a long distance by name Reddy. He came out of his office and requested me to take some rest in his office and offered me a cup of coffee. Well, then Reddy said, "Sir, I could not attend your talk today because I am on duty. I very much regret about it. In fact, I have been longing to listen to you because many people have been speaking about your talks for the last several years. But anyway, within this brief time, would you tell me briefly what you spoke at the meeting and bless me?" Then I started telling him some of the points I mentioned there. "My weakness is this. The moment I start speaking on Swami, I'm beyond time and space. I forget where I am. I forget the time constraint. When once he asked me to say a few words about Swami, I was excited and started speaking. After some time he said, Reddy garu, the superintendent of railway station in Khazipet, he said, sir, time up for the train to come. Let's go to the railway platform. By the time when both of us came out of his office to the platform, the train already reached and left. The train crossed signal point. It was the Godavari Express. At that time, it was one of the trains that run very fast. And my other colleague, the other speaker, Subrahmanya Sarma, the principal of A.V.M college, Visakhapatnam, he was feeling very sorry. "Mr. Anil Kumar, how am I to go to college tomorrow? How are you going to attend your college tomorrow? Both of us missed the train. I would not have joined you. I feel so sorry about this." Then I was praying within myself, "Swami, this gentleman is feeling so bad to have missed the train." Well, he is quite genuine in feeling so. Being the principal, he must go and report to duty. "I'm so sorry, Swami. You should save me. The train left, crossed the signal point. I don't know how you are going to solve the problem. I was just praying to Swami silently within. Believe me or not, the train started moving backwards, from the signal point back to the railway platform. It never happens. The train that crossed the signal point will never come back. That to an express train. I could not believe myself. Then immediately asked the colleague, Subrahmanya Sarma, sir, let's board the train. And both of us left to our places and attended our colleges. This I am telling you, that when we do Swami's duty, He will take care of us in every way. He will not disappoint us. Because His service to Him will never go in vain. It will never put us to any kind of risk whatsoever. Train running backwards to pick up both of us. How am I to reconcile? Even now I am not able to believe it to have happened. Then I would give you another experience. I had been to some places there, to Karimnagar in the state of Telangana. Well, after the talk, I could get into the train, and the train was running late. I should report to duty. Usually what I used to do was to go to the college straight from the station to attend to my duty. Because that's a Christian college, highly disciplined. That too, when I say I went for a meeting of Sai Baba, well, I'll be kicked out of the college. So, the train was late, delayed. What am I to do? Then somehow, hesitatingly, slowly, I went to the college. What happened? What did I see there? The whole premises, campus was empty. The main door was locked. Then I called the watchman. What happened? Sir, today, one of our lecturers got married, and therefore today is declared a holiday. Oh, I thanked Swami profusely. Swami, may the bachelors get married in such a way that I would have time to do your work, and I would also enjoy the holiday. That's what I prayed within myself. This is a proof to let you know how Swami will save you. Because if you walk one step with me, I'll walk with you 10 steps. That's what Bhagavan said. As Baba said, if you do my work, it is my duty to do your work. I should also give you another example. I had been to Nagpur in the state of Maharashtra. Addressed Nagpur University students and such size centers there, and could board Dakshin Express there at Nagpur. Then the train was delayed. Train was running late, very late, 2 hours late. What am I to do? I went straight to the college. Believe me or not, to my utter surprise, the whole campus was empty. Doors are closed. I called the watchman, what happened, Ra? What happened today? Sir, all students assembled in the auditorium. there is some meeting there. You go there straight. So, without taking time, I rush to the college auditorium. There is a big meeting. Our college has the strength of 4,500 students. The auditorium was fully packed. I listen to claps from a distance. Thundering sound. I was very happy. I went close to the auditorium and stood at the back. I could notice that it was a celebration at the intercollegiate cricket match. Our college stood first, and the cricketers were presented with silver cups, and the ever-rolling shield was received by the principal, and all students were clapping, hilarious laughter. They're very, very happy. At the end, the principal came and announced, as our students stood first at the intercollegiate cricket competitions, today is declared holiday. I was extremely happy and prayed to Swami within myself, Bhagavan, let our students play like this. Let them win prizes like this. And let me have holidays to do your work and have my job safe in your hands. That's what had happened. What am I to say? How Swami saved me? I would have lost my job long back, you know, because of my frequent travels. Swami said, every time. Maybe it is our mistake to have not prayed to him. And it is a sin to have not participated in his divine mission. So it is for us to take up this challenge, and Swami will certainly come to rescue. Once I went to certain districts like Adilabad, Nizamabad, which are full of Naxalites at one time. Police suspected the movement of Naxalites, the men of violence, on the main highway road, main highway. Police suspected. So there's patrolling. Police people were moving in all directions. While watching my car returning around 12 o'clock in the night, at every place, the car was stopped. And police started peeping through the window with guns. Well, I may be shot also, because they got all the powers, because Naxalites. Finish, I can be finished within no time. But every time the policeman just projects his neck through the window, watches Swami's photo, now you go. Everywhere it happened like that. The car was stopped, police checked, and then asked me to go, watching Swami's photo like that. Then later, I came to Prasanthalayam. Swami said, you have no sense of time. He seemed to be a mad fellow. What nonsense you did. You travel in the midnight? Did I not tell you not to travel after 10 o'clock in the night? That you traveled in the Naxalite area? Police have got every power to shoot anybody at that time. You should have been shot dead. Do you know that? The whole night, I had to watch you. The whole night, I had to protect you. What will happen to your family? Immediately, I fell at his feet, washed his feet with tears, and then, Swami, I beg your pardon. Hereafter, I don't travel after 10. But at the same time, I'm happy, Bhagavan, that you were with me throughout the night, taking care of my safety. That you are in the car, behind me, with me, above me. Swami, I am ever grateful to you. Then Bhagavan said, don't repeat this, he said. This I am sharing with you to let you know how Swami guards us, how Swami takes care of us. Therefore, let us participate in His divine mission unhesitatingly, more enthusiastically than ever before. Thank you. Meet again.